I'm James Freeman. I'm chairman and founder of the Friends of King Alfred Buses. We have been preserving King Alfred Buses since 1985. We exist to preserve the memory of the bus company that ran in Winchester, King Alfred Motor Services, whose buses started and finished in Winchester Broadway next to King Alfred's statue. They did that from 1915 till 1973, so they've been gone for nearly 50 years. And our group is dedicated to finding and restoring every single King Alfred bus left. So each year we have an event when people can come to Winchester and ride over their old routes on the King Alfred buses.
Anybody here today ride on a King Alfred bus when we had King Alfred buses? Anybody? Only my dad. Oh no, and one more. And me, but not on the number four. But if you buy a programme, all the proceeds go towards ensuring these buses are kept up together and we don't have to charge you to come on them.
The fare collection and supervising the passengers is all down to the conductor. So this bus would always have operated with two people. And actually, King Alfred Motor Services never went to the one-man operation.
Well, welcome aboard this number four route from the King Alfred buses, just to tell you something about what we're doing today. The King Alfred buses were the private company that ran the municipal buses for the city of Winchester from the 1920s until April 1973.
In April 1973, 28th of April 1973 is a day I shall never forget, and at that point the services were taken over by Hants and Dorset, which was a local bus company operated by the National Bus Company, and they were all integrated. So Hants and Dorset had a depot in Winchester, and they ran services outside the city, mainly to Southampton and places like that, Fareham, and so that was all merged together. And the King Alfred green colours disappeared, the statues vanished, and the buses were painted red. That's a National Bus Company standard poppy red. It looked quite nice when they were first painted, but they tended to fade with time. And that was the end of the King Alfred Motor Services, except that we came along. Well, I found this bus. I was working at the time for the South Wales Transport Company in South Wales, and I saw this bus drive by, and I said to somebody, oh, that bus is, that's an old King Alfred bus. And about 6 weeks later, somebody came to see me and said, that bus you saw, that's for sale, £600. Get yourself down to Inans and see if you can buy it. So I took myself off to Inans, and sure enough, they were saying, oh yeah, you can buy that, that's right. So it only had third and fourth gear working, so first and second not available. It had oil in the water and water in the oil, which was not a good thing. It was missing a seat from the front, and it was sold as found, as it were. But I bought it, and it was the start of, it was the first bus. And then in 1983 I bought a second bus, and then in 1985 I realised I couldn't do this on my own and I needed a group of supporters, people to help. And that's how we set up the Friends of King Alfred Buses. And we've never looked back from that, 1985, so that's 36 years. Oh, blimey. Yes, so, you know, we have about 250 members. And we're always looking for more. So if it's you, come along.
All volunteers.
All volunteers.
Formed by a man called Mr. Robert Chisnell. He started off bringing soldiers down from the Mournhill barracks up by St. Giles Hill and bringing them down into the town for subsistence, and found he could make a bit of money by doing that. So he created a formal company to do PSVs, and he created a timetable starting with half a dozen routes around Winchester and the surrounding villages in 1922, I think, was the first official timetable.
Well, I can't tell you what it is in feet, but what I can tell you is that what really matters, and it's a real test for King Alfred drivers nowadays, the friends of King Alfred Buses drivers, is you have to be able to make a U-turn in Winchester Broadway. So the bus has to be on one side and then it has to be on the other, and the only way around is one is to go around, and you need to go around in one. And all our buses will do it just. But some of them it's very tight and you have to be very close to one side to do it, and you need to know the technique to get it round in one go. Reversing on the U-turn is a terrible thing to do. You need to get round in one go. They're quite agile, these buses. It always surprises people when they're close behind another vehicle. It's amazing how you can get out behind them, because the wheels will come round. They have good lock. Even so, the Winchester Broadway is the test. Well, it gives you much better traction. So a nice big wheel means you have plenty of leverage, and that's important because you'll be pulling the lever around, you know, the wheel round, and nice, easy. And of course, the style is that way. You never cross your left hands like that. You're always feeding that round. And this wheel makes that really easy. So the bigger the wheel, the better. Well, there is only that power. You just learn, for example, to use the motion of the vehicle and steer while the vehicle is moving, because once it's stopped, you really can't turn the wheel. The more it's rolling, the better it is. So buses that are full, lots of people on them, are heavier. So that makes the steering heavier. And if they're going very slowly, it makes it heavy.
They carried on through the Second World War, but as it got to the 70s, it became harder and harder to find men and women who would work for the bus company, because there were better opportunities in other jobs at the time. And therefore, that's why in April 1973, the company got absolved by the Hanson Dorset, and King Alfred Buses were no more. The friends of King Alfred Buses own all the vehicles that you see today with King Alfred on them. And there are 14 in total that the group own, and it's believed to be every King Alfred bus that exists. Though we are more than happy to hear that you know where the 15th is.
Thank you very much. Every passenger who pays a fare on a King Alfred bus needs to have a ticket. And the original way of giving people tickets was using this machine. Now, this is a Bell Punch ticket machine. These were very, very widely used across the British transport industry. And the principle they adopt is that they make a hole in the ticket, and that hole is then kept within the machine. And later on, you can open the machine up and look at all the holes that you've collected. And what the conductors had was each ticket value was a different colour. So a penny one would be, let's say, red, a sixpenny one might be blue, and a shilling one might be green. So whoever was counting the little bits only had to look for how many green ones, how many blue ones, how many red ones, and they could work out how much money had been issued through this machine. And the conductor's takings needed to tally with that. Now, it was called the Bell Punch, and the reason for that was that the only way you could get a valid ticket out of it, tickets in the slot, did you hear the ring? So let's make another hole. So everybody could tell that the conductor had issued a valid ticket, because the Bell Punch rang out. And the little bit of ticket, the little hole, has gone into here. And now there are two little white holes in there. So they know that whatever this ticket value was, let's say it was a penny, so they've issued tuppence worth of tickets. So they're looking for tuppence. So The great thing about this system was that it was pretty foolproof, but it was really hard to manipulate. So you needed people with very good sight and little pins going through, because you can imagine a conductor would probably issue, what, 500-600 tickets in a day. Can you imagine thousands and thousands of little bits of card to count up? So it was a difficult system. Nonetheless, it worked continuously right the way through to the 1940s, when people started looking around for better answers.
So this is absolutely original material, and of course completely irreplaceable. There's always a big question, well, should we let people sit on these seats? Well, yes, because the whole thing about this is the experience of riding on the bus. And for me, the thing that brings it alive is the sound and the movement. And also, when it's busy, would you believe the smell? Because the bus starts to smell of hot oils and all those sort of things. It smells of bodies. And you might say, well, that's a bit weird. But actually, that really does recapture what it might have been like to go riding on these buses 60 years ago.
Some of the buses you see have been brought back from America. Some have come from Ireland, all from scrapyards or in fields, and brought back to life as you see them today.
Quite a lot of work involved. The one good thing it did have, though, the engine started, and it runs very well.
I'm Henry Pratt. I'm a volunteer and trustee of Friends of King Alfred Buses.
So the very last fare-taking trip that was ever done by King Alfred Buses was the 10:35 p.m. on the Route 13 to Week Estate. And when the bus turned up to do that route, they found there were so many people wanted to have a last ride with the King Alfred Buses, they brought a second bus in. And the two buses followed, one followed the other all the way around Week Estate and back down to Broadway. So the bus that came second, the relief bus that was brought in, was the last passenger fare-taking bus that King Alfred's ever had. And it was this bus. This is the last fare-taking bus that King Alfred's ever had at 22:35 in April 1973. So it's quite a special bus, this one. We own two of these, and these are our new girls. These are only 1970. We have buses going back to the 1930s. The route you're on now is number 4. You can always tell how old the routes are because we started at number 1, very logical, the Chisnells, and when they added routes, they just went up sequentially. So number 4 was one of the first routes that they ever ran. You'll notice there is not a Route 14. That's because the Aldershot and District Bus Company, their route to Winchester was the number 14. And apparently in those days, people could get very confused by having two buses with 14 on them. So we never had one.
One for stop, two for go. But of course on a conductor, on this sort of bus, the conductor would just have come down to the front of the bus like this and said, right away driver, or next stop please. You never rang the bell in reality. But the double deckers, you rang the bell all the time. So that next stop please. And when the people had got off, safe to go. And there was one other, bus 4. Keep going. don't stop. This is a Leyland Titan. It's one of 13 Leyland Titans in the King Alfred fleet. But this is not a Leyland body because in 1954, Leyland decided that they were just going to concentrate on building chassis and no longer build bodies. So in this case, King Alfred went to East Lancashire Coach Builders in Blackburn, not far down the road from Leyland. This has the characteristic upstairs arrangement with four seats on one side and a sunken gangway. In terms of its history, when it finished in Winchester in 1972, it was bought by a company called Omnibus Promotions, and they painted it red and stuck Trafalgar Square in the destination and London Transport on the side and sent it to the United States. Eventually, the phone rang in my office and an American voice said, what does the number PLU494 mean to you? And I said, it's a long lost King Alfred bus. He said, it's outside my window. He then invited us to go and look at it, and I went with a friend across to Augusta, Georgia, and we looked at his bus, and he said, but I don't want you to have it. Anyway, to cut a very, very long story short, eventually, after about 5 years, in 1993, and we drove it from Augusta to Jacksonville, Florida, which is a 2 days drive across the interstates of the United States, put it on a boat and sent it back to England. It then took us 5 years to rebuild it. And what you see is the result of that effort. So 1998, this was relaunched, having been pretty well reconstructed in the body. And it's a fine vehicle. Makes some very characteristic sounds, very typical of its age. So you can imagine, as a bus conductor, you had to get used to running in a constantly moving vehicle. So to take fares, you would lodge yourself against the seat back in that way, and then you could do your business without being thrown all over everything. There were techniques even about walking around the bus. When you look at the front of the bus, you can see the destination gear. Nowadays, this is all done with LED, but we do it with a handle. So if we want to change the display on the front, that's how you do it.
we're looking to our members for support in every way. So physical support, so coming to help us fix the buses and run the buses, but also putting their hands in their pockets. So many of our members are very generous over time and help us to buy things that we need or to pay for the costs. And of course, you can imagine that preserving an old bus in the modern world is a very, very expensive pastime. And we also need money from outsiders. So that's what our events are about, our running days and things like that, where people can come and either join the Friends of King Alfred Buses or buy our merchandise of various kinds or other things that we sell, and or simply donate money. And people do donate very generously.
Yeah, but in any event, the prices have gone through the roof, so I think they
it's nearly 3:45 on our running day, Sunday the 12th of September, and we're pretty well through, thank goodness. And it's been a great day. The sun has shone most of the day. It's not shining now, but it's been shining since early. And we've had lots of people come from all over everywhere, lots of old friends, and we've managed to run pretty well all the trips we were hoping to do. We're very pleased, despite having several breakdowns and difficulties, but it's always like that, and we're only replicating real life after all. So we've really enjoyed ourselves, and I hope that lots of other people have enjoyed themselves too, which is the whole idea of this.
Thank you for watching. My special thanks to all members of Friends of King Alfred Buses. Thanks for everyone helping to make this video. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Hello Wallace.